Good evening. Give me some more. Good evening. Welcome to Dabney S. Lancaster Community College 54th Commencement Service. Please stand and welcome our graduates as they come in and remain standing.
Thank you. Please remain standing for our national anthem, sung by Mahaley Rains, a 2016 DSLCC graduate, and the DSLCC alma mater, sung by James and Nancy Mathias.
Whose broad stripes and bright stars.
Be seated. Good evening. On behalf of the Chancellor of the Virginia Community College System, the State Board for Community Colleges, the College Local Board, faculty, staff, I welcome you to the 54th Commencement Exercises and Pinning Ceremony for Dabney S. Lancaster Community College. Before we begin, I ask that all of you, if you could please silence your cell phones. And I also ask that you keep your masks on at all times and remain in your seats for the entire ceremony. It's important that we continue to do our part to keep socially distant for today's ceremony. Welcome proud parents, grandparents, husbands and wives, brothers and sisters, aunts and uncles, cousins, and friends of our graduates. Thank you all for being here. Welcome dedicated faculty, staff, board members, alumni, and the business community. And welcome and congratulations to the class of 2021. To get us started, I'd like to introduce a very different and lonely platform party. Usually there's 7 or 8 people up here. But I have the pleasure of introducing Dr. Benjamin Wirth, Vice President of Academic Affairs, and Dr. Kathy Heiler, Program Head of Nursing. Thank you both for being here. If you're not reading your program, I'm John Rinone, proud president of the college, and I have the honor of welcoming all of you here today. Today is a special day. You did it. You are here today with your family and friends to celebrate this major accomplishment. The emergence of the COVID-19 pandemic is unlike anything we have seen in our lifetime. Despite the tremendous uncertainty over the last year, you, as working parents, first-generation college students, and workers on the front lines of the COVID-19 pandemic, stuck with your studies and persisted against all odds. You demonstrated incredible grit and determination, and we today celebrate your remarkable achievements. As hard as it has been for students to make this transition, it has also been equally challenging for the faculty to shift their mindset to online and remote instruction. Like you, they value the interactions in the classroom, and they miss, for the most part, your face-to-face conversations. They miss you coming into class, laughing, and leaving knowing that you learned something new that day. Like you, they also had to navigate unfamiliar territory to continue to provide high levels of academic engagement. I could not be prouder of everyone who came together for one purpose, you, the DSLCC student. In the words of George Boggs, a retired president and CEO of the American Association of Community Colleges, teachers are truly scholars who work magic both for their community and for their lives of their students. Please help me thank all your faculty. One of these amazing faculty members is retiring at the end of this semester, and I would like to recognize her today. Would Beverly Ellis Smith please stand to be recognized for the many years of service and dedication to your students? The DSLCC community thanks you. Today we celebrate a commencement, a beginning or start. As someone who believes in lifelong learning, it is my hope that this is only the beginning of your educational journey. What's also important to recognize is that 50 years ago, a high school education was sufficient to get a good job to support your family. However, in the 21st century, it takes some form of post-secondary education to get such a job. In making the decision to go to college, you have opened up a door to a completely new world of opportunity. The more education you attain, the more doors you will open. Do not mistake the numbers of you wearing caps and gowns as signs that graduating from college is easy. We know it's not. Enrolling in college takes courage. As I was, you may be the first in your family to attend college. Finishing with a degree or certificate takes perseverance. Having done it, you join a minority that remains much too small in America today. Among the many technical skills you gained while at DSLCC, you are also equipped with the knowledge and skills to act on your values and make the world a better place. College changed me, as I hope it has done you. My curiosity grew, and so did my confidence. I hope it did for you as well. Just like any journey, you could not do this alone. Everyone needs help, and I'm sure the ones you owe a large debt, possibly beyond repaying, is your family. Let me ask all the graduates that after the ceremony, you go to your families and thank them personally for their support. You probably could not have done it without them. For now, graduates, let's give your family a round of applause to thank all of them for everything that they did for you. In a short while, we will be conferring degrees and certificates on a number of amazing people who have worked to improve themselves, the future of their families, and the communities where we live and work. Because that's what education does. Education provides a pathway to success, to careers, and to opportunity. A degree, certificate, or industry credential provides concrete skills and serves as the only reliable predictor towards success. Your degree or certificate is an important signal to the world that you have worked hard, you have sought after skills that will lead you to better careers and better lives. However, your degree doesn't entitle you to success. It only lets you play the game. Your character is your success factor. We know that DSLCC graduates have character. We have veterans who have served this country with distinction. We have graduates who work two or three part-time jobs to make ends meet, or even lost a job during the pandemic. We have graduates who needed to juggle work, family, and school. We have graduates here today despite of their disabilities. Eleanor Roosevelt said, "The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams." Today, you realize the beautiful dream by graduating from DSLCC. We are incredibly proud of you, and thank you and congratulations. It is now my pleasure to introduce Stephen Vaughn, our local board chair, to provide greetings.
Chairman of the Dabney S. Lancaster Community College Local Board and a representative from Botetourt County. On behalf of President John Rinone and local board members, welcome students and the proud families of these students, as well as the college's faculty and staff and visitors to this very exciting, significant day in the life of the 2021 DSLCC graduates. We are happy you chose Dabney S. Lancaster College to continue your educational journey. Graduation from DSLCC is like a bridge to the next part of your life. Everything that got you here, hard work, drive, and confidence, is going to carry you across this bridge to the future you deserve. May you always dare to achieve, broaden your worldview, show your gratitude, inspire others, and give back to the community. Congratulations on a job well done.
The Gary Lee Miller Outstanding Graduate Award honors First Lieutenant Gary Lee Miller, a Covington, Virginia native who was killed in action in Vietnam. Mr. Miller was born on March 19, 1947, and graduated from Covington High School in 1965. He attended Dabney S. Lancaster Community College before joining the United States Army. On February 16, 1969, while Mr. Miller was on patrol with his battalion, they were attacked and he was seriously wounded. During the engagement, an enemy grenade was thrown at the patrol, and in spite of his wounds, Lieutenant Miller threw himself on the grenade to save his men. His battalion nominated him for the Congressional Medal of Honor, which was awarded to Lieutenant Miller posthumously for his extraordinary courage and selflessness. In addition to this building being named for Lieutenant Miller, Miller Hall stands at Fort Benning, Georgia, in his honor. Nominated and selected by faculty and staff, this year's recipient embodies Lieutenant Miller's spirit of service. This year's recipient serves our community as a Justice Ambassador for Prison Fellowship, a Sunday school teacher at Marlbrook Baptist Church, and was on the president's list for two semesters at DSLCC. She is also involved with the local PTO in Rockbridge County Schools and serves in the My Father's Hand Outreach Program. Most recently, this year's recipient led a grassroots effort to serve youth in the Rockbridge area by establishing educational pods. These pods provide educational assistance to over 160 children in 11 different locations during the COVID-19 global pandemic. On behalf of all DSLCC faculty and staff, I am pleased and honored to present the 2021 Gary Lee Miller Outstanding Graduate Award to Brandy Mitchell. Thank you. Ms. Mitchell will receive the award on Saturday. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Wirth. I now have the pleasure of introducing the 2021 DSLCC Distinguished Alumni Award. Ashby Clements is living proof that a four-year college degree isn't a requirement in order to enjoy a career that not only earns him a good living, but also brings him a lot of satisfaction. The Rockbridge County welder is an entrepreneur who started his own business with plans in the very near future to purchase another business where he has been employed in the last few years. Established in 2017, the award is presented to a DSLCC alumnus or alumna who has realized exemplary distinction in their profession and honors all those at the college who have assisted them on the path to success, enabling them to enrich their communities. Clements, who was homeschooled by his mom with his two siblings, grew up on a farm near Buena Vista. He says he fell into a career in welding by chance. I didn't know anything about welding, but I figured knowing how to weld would be a great skill on the farm, said, and Dabney Welding Program had a good reputation. He spent three semesters at DSLCC earning a welding certificate in 2015. He credits Mike Bryant, welding program head, for his success. Ashby takes off a few weeks every year for the past 5 years to attend to a ministry his family created called East Four West Navajo Ministries. The nonprofit serves thousands of people in poverty on the Navajo Indian Reservation that covers several states. Clements also heads up a Christmas gift program that serves as many as 3,000 Navajo children, and he is also the head coach for the ministry soccer camp, a tuition-free camp that takes place annually on the Navajo Reservation. Clements credits his mother, Virginia, with giving him a solid education and a love for service. He will be recognized formally at tomorrow evening's commencement, but please help me congratulate Ashby Clements with the 2021 Distinguished Alumni Award.
I have the pleasure of introducing your speaker tonight, Linda Thomas, MSNRN. Linda is a clinical professional development educator for Southwest Virginia Market of Lewis Gale Hospital. Her home hospital is Lewis Gale Allegheny. She earned her Associates of Science in Nursing from Dabney S. Lancaster Community College, her Bachelor of Science degree in Nursing from Virginia Commonwealth University Medical College of Virginia, and her Master's of Science in Nursing Education from Western Governors University. She has over 30 years of nursing experience, with a large portion of her experience devoted to education. She is a member of the American Nurses Association, the Virginia Nurses Association, and the Association of Nursing Professional Development. Please welcome me and help me welcome Linda Thomas.
Good evening. Good evening. You did it. Yes, you did it. A day that looks so far away is finally here. Thank your family, your friends, your educators, and most importantly, yourself. I feel truly humbled and honored to be given the opportunity to be a part of your nurse pinning ceremony this evening. You have met your goal of completing your associate degree of nursing despite the challenges you have endured over the past year. A global pandemic brought about multiple changes that many here today have never experienced in their lifetime. The familiar routines that we often took for granted suddenly changed. The pandemic changed the way we live and the way we interact. Colleges and educational programs were forced to transition to virtual online learning. Clinical practicum presented an even larger challenge as guidelines and requirements were implemented that decreased the ability for students to work directly with patients in healthcare facilities. As if nursing wasn't already stressful, losing a connection with family and friends during a time where physical interaction and support were profoundly needed intensified the stress level. But you persevered. You accepted the indetermination of change. You embraced the uncertainty that was placed before you. You utilized the power of radical acceptance. You accepted the way that things were at the moment. You became more resilient, which helped you to embrace life's challenges. Through your courage and determination, you've succeeded, which is truly a testament of commitment. You became aspiring nurses who made one of the greatest choices to enter a demanding yet rewarding career. A famous philosopher quoted, "Change is the only constant in life," which is so true. Change is going to occur. It's what strategies we incorporate to embrace that change. Change is learning. And if anything, over the last year, we all have learned and grown in the process. Life is precious, and as a nurse, you have and will understand the importance of just how precious it is. You will be there to provide a glimmer of hope, render a smile, or wipe away a tear of pain or sorrow for your patient. Nursing is a work of art, and you will be grateful every day that you are a part of it. Remember how you act and how you speak. The extra time you take with your patient, which all may be a part of a normal work day for you, but it can impact and be a treasure of remembrance to your patients and their loved ones for the rest of their lives. Our patients are coming in to us with more complex health conditions. Critical thinking and clinical reasoning is a vital framework. A framework of ensuring we are approaching intense situations with a greatest perspective, effective decision making, and evidence-based practice to provide to our patients the utmost quality and safe care that they so deserve. Let me tell you a story about how nursing impacted a little blonde-haired, blue-eyed girl starting at the young age of 4. The little girl loved her father with all her heart. After all, he had been by her side since her birth. The little girl's father started experiencing some intense abdominal pain and was found to have a bleeding gastric ulcer. Through many diagnostic tests, the father was scheduled for a Billy-Roth II surgical procedure, which involved a partial gastrectomy and a gastrojejunostomy. The little girl made sure her father was being given the best of treatment, as she informed the nurse she wanted her daddy to get all better. Throughout the little girl's growing years, she never missed an opportunity to take care of any living organism, from the dog who had been tagged by a car and suffered a few abrasions, to her goldfish who was lying upside down in the aquarium. And she and her father had to prepare the burial resting place together. As the little girl lifted the fish out of the water, it started to flip-flop in her hand. She was ecstatic and overjoyed that she had revived her goldfish for a few more years. Her father should have taken stock and invested in Johnson & Johnson Band-Aids, as most of them were used on her dolls and make-believe boo-boos. After high school graduation, the now little girl had grown into a young woman and still had the ambition to help people. Her goal was to become a nurse. She met with the college advisor and was handed the list of prerequisites to enter the nursing program. She felt it would be very challenging since she had a 2-year-old daughter at the time. She was, however, engaged and committed to achieve the goal that she had set. With her father's help to watch her daughter to provide her study time throughout the program, she received her associate degree in nursing at the age of 22. Her beautiful daughter and father, gleaming in the audience as she received her pin during the pinning ceremony and respectively graduated from the nursing program. School didn't stop there for this young woman. She loved learning and was committed to gain further knowledge, skills, and attitudes to improve her educational opportunities. Several years later, she pursued and was 6 months from obtaining her Bachelor of Nursing degree when her father was diagnosed, became very ill, and succumbed to lung cancer. Her ambition of obtaining her BSN no longer seemed important. After all, the father who had always been there throughout her entire life cheering her on, and providing encouragement was no longer there. Her response was her father would not see her obtaining another milestone in her life. So what was the purpose of completion? The purpose betrayed before her was provided and resignated within the woman through her daughters, who at the age of 16 and 7 also lost a valuable mentor themselves, their pawpaw. You see, she was provided the strength to walk in the ceremony, this time with her daughters, hands enclasped in hers, and the feeling of her father's presence as she was awarded her BSN diploma. Education has always been an integral part of this woman's life and growth. Learning has and will never stop. We have many facets of life that makes us truly human. Being an educator is one of the most rewarding careers in the world. You see, there is a difference in being a teacher and an educator. A teacher instructs and disseminates educational content, specific skills, and knowledge within a curriculum. An educator may also provide those skills of achievement, but provides inspiration, support, encouragement, and growth in the learner. Education is a lifelong process. That blonde-haired, blue-eyed little girl in the story mentioned above was also a Dabney S. Lancaster nursing graduate. She is standing before you today. That little girl was me. I became that child nurse and followed and achieved many educational goals. A few years back, I obtained my Master of Nursing degree in education. Presently, I am preparing to obtain my education as a nursing professional development practitioner. The moral of this story is never give up. Nursing is a wonderful and rewarding career with a magnitude of opportunities. As a nurse, you will forever be learning because your goals should always have your patient's best interests at heart. Always follow your heart, set, prioritize, commit, and achieve your goals and opportunities laid before you. You have achieved the goal of completing your nursing program. The next goal of achievement on your list may be sitting for the NCLEX. Whatever the goal is, challenge yourself. Nothing worth having comes easy. I leave with you a quote from the late Maya Angelou, an award-winning author and poet, who was a speaker at my BSN commencement. I've learned that people will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel. Congratulations, 2021 Nursing Dabney S. Lancaster School of Nursing. I wish you all the best in the future you have set before you. Thank you.
And now for the moment you've been waiting for. Graduates, congratulations. Your hard work and hours of dedication have brought you to this moment. Your achievements are to be commended. Will the 2021 candidates for graduation at Dabney S. Lancaster Community College please rise? President Ranone, on behalf of the faculty, staff, and administration, it is my pleasure to present and recommend for graduation the Dabney S. Lancaster Community College Class of 2021.
Vested in me by the Chancellor of the Community College System, the State Board for Community Colleges, and by the Commonwealth of Virginia, I hereby confer upon each of you, as appropriate to your course of study, the degree of Associate of Arts and Sciences or the Associate of Applied Science and/or certificates, along with the rights, privileges, and responsibilities appertaining thereunto. My congratulations to each of you.
Krista Michelle Armstrong. Reagan Nicole Bess, Associate Degree in Nursing, magna cum laude. Michaela Hunter Boggs, Associate Degree in Nursing. Kayla Charmaine Carroll, Associate Degree in Nursing. Megan Lee Kraft, Associate Degree in Nursing, cum laude. Brittany Marie Downer, Associate Degree in Nursing, magna cum laude. Qu- Courtney Dressler, Associate Degree in Nursing, magna cum laude. Kennedy Eastman, Associate Degree in Nursing, Certificate in Advanced Healthcare, cum laude. Megan Dawn Freeman, Associate Degree in Nursing. Brianna Marie Gordon, Associate Degree in Nursing. Anna Lee Grant, Associate Degree in Nursing. Christine Elizabeth Hall, Associate Degree in Nursing. Emily Sue Ann Hamilton, Associate Degree in Nursing, magna cum laude, PTK All-State Academic Team. Allison Hassan, Associate Degree in Nursing, cum laude. Whitney Fitzgerald Helmentoler, Associate Degree in Nursing, Certificate in Advanced Healthcare. Rose Catherine Hensley, Associate Degree in Nursing, Certificate in Advanced Healthcare. Hannah Nicole Hubbard, Associate Degree in Nursing, Magna Cum Laude. Dana Lee Hunter, Associate Degree in Nursing, Cum Laude. Amber Michelle Lester, Associate Degree in Nursing, Cum Laude. Ashley Little, Associate Degree in Nursing, Cum Laude. Brittany Morgan Nicely, Associate Degree in Nursing, Certificate in Advanced Healthcare, Magna Cum Laude. Sierra Moore, Associate Degree in Nursing. Erica Nicole Martin, Associate Degree in Nursing, Certificate in Advanced Healthcare, Cum Laude. Daryl Wayne Loudermilk, Associate Degree in Nursing, Cum Laude. Courtney Lynn Paxton, Associate Degree in Nursing. Thank you. Danielle M. Rock, Associate Degree in Nursing. Amy Catherine C., Associate Degree in Nursing. Carter Ann Shiflett, Associate Degree in Nursing. Mary Vance, Associate Degree in Nursing, cum laude. Josie Noelle Spangler, Associate Degree in Nursing, Certificate in Advanced Healthcare, cum laude. McKenna Paige Smith, Associate Degree in Nursing, Magna Cum Laude, Phi Theta Kappa. Kimberly P. Smedley, Associate Degree in Nursing, Phi Theta Kappa. Kara Brooke Villa, Associate Degree in Nursing, Certificate in Advanced Healthcare, Magna Cum Laude. Christina Huffman Villa, Associate Degree in Nursing. Tabitha Blanche Wells, Associate Degree in Nursing. Rachel Marie Wolfe, Associate Degree in Nursing, Certificate in Advanced Healthcare. Mary Elizabeth Woods, Associate Degree in Nursing. Michaela Brianne Allwine, Certificate in Practical Nursing, magna cum laude. Samantha Nicole Avril, Certificate in Practical Nursing, magna cum laude. Jada Ann Beck, Certificate in Practical Nursing, cum laude. Erica M. Beverly, Certificate in Practical Nursing. Evan Hunter Brads, Certificate in Practical Nursing, summa cum laude. Bonnie Dudley Branham, Certificate in Practical Nursing. Thank you. Sarah Elizabeth Krantz, Certificate in Practical Nursing. Caitlin Rose Crawford, Certificate in Practical Nursing, cum laude. Kyle Aaron Fisher, Certificate in Practical Nursing, cum laude. Madison Blair Fox, Certificate in Practical Nursing, cum laude. Tanya Jill Holman, Certificate in Practical Nursing, cum laude. Haley Jennings, Certificate in Practical Nursing. Brittany A. Kinsey, Certificate in Practical Nursing, cum laude. Madison Danielle Lawson, Certificate in Practical Nursing. Sarah Lee, Certificate in Practical Nursing, Advanced Healthcare. Katie Elizabeth Michaels, Certificate in Practical Nursing, cum laude. Brenna Eubank Robertson, Certificate in Practical Nursing. Willow R. Scholl, Certificate in Practical Nursing, cum laude. Tiffany Lynn Sloan, Certificate in Practical Nursing. Sativa St. Clair, Certificate in Practical Nursing, magna cum laude. Savannah Lee Worley, Certificate in Practical Nursing, summa cum laude. Shayla Brianne Wolf, Certificate in Practical Nursing, summa cum laude. Brianna Lee Wright, Certificate in Practical Nursing, cum laude.
We will now do the lighting of the lamp. Florence Nightingale, an English nurse and pioneer reformer, was born in Florence, Italy on May 12, 1820 and died August 13, 1910. Many modern nursing techniques can be traced back to her. History was made during the Crimean War when Florence took 38 women to Turkey to nurse sick and wounded British soldiers. The British government had never before permitted women to do this. Because of her selfless duty during the Crimean War, Florence Nightingale became known as the Lady with the Lamp. As a tribute to Florence's dedication, the lamp icon became symbolic of nursing. The lamp will always shine brightly as a symbol of the care and devotion the nurse administers to the sick and injured in the practice of nursing. Will all nurses in the audience stand, and we will recite the Florence Nightingale Pledge. I solemnly pledge before myself, before God, and in the presence of this assembly, to practice my profession faithfully and devote myself to the welfare of those committed to my care. I will abstain from whatever is deleterious and mischievous, and will not take or knowingly administer any harmful drug. I will do all in my power to maintain and elevate the standard of my profession, and will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping and all family matters coming to my knowledge in the practice of my profession.
Nurses' hands. You have been educated and trained in the art of nursing. Now you are prepared to accomplish great things with your hands. Blessed be your hands that are anointed to care for the sick and offer blessings of healing. Blessed be your hands that will touch many lives. Blessed be your hands that will feel the pain of others. Blessed be your hands that will embrace with compassion. Blessed be your hands that will administer medicine to improve health. Blessed be your hands that will bathe, cleanse, and comfort. Blessed be your hands that will console the dying and calm their families. Blessed be your hands that, when they grow stiff with age, they will feel the assurance of the many lives they have touched. Blessed be your hands. You will hold the future in your hands. Blessed be your hands, for may they do divine work on earth.
You can now extinguish your candles.
Please be seated. Graduates, I welcome you to the ranks of great women and men educated in the American collegiate tradition. You now may do one last symbolic thing, and for those wearing their caps, you may move your tassel from the right side of your cap to the left side to signify you have graduated. Congratulations to all of you. Like to take this time just to close our commencement to the final remarks and announcements. First of all, you will find this recording available on YouTube. And as a reminder, as we exit the gym today, please remember that the graduates on the floor will exit first from the back to the front, then the faculty, then the platform party. Our guests will be escorted one row at a time using two doors. A guide will lead you to the exits. As always, we ask that you not gather outside in large groups and try to keep 6 feet apart. Finally, as we leave here today, ready to turn your hard work and your dreams into reality, I hope that you will never lose the will to learn. You reach one goal here today, but remember this is an intermediate goal that has prepared you to take another step forward. As you seek to make a difference in life, I would like to leave you to ponder the words of author James Baldwin. Not everything that is faced can be changed, but but nothing can be changed unless it is faced. The best leaders the world has ever known are the reformers who were accountable and responsible for their own change. The commitment for change has no days off, does not allow for excuses, and does not allow for pardons. Each one of us can leave a stamp on this world by making our lives meaningful in a thousand ways and making the lives of others better than they ever thought possible. If you want to see change, you must first start within. It's that simple and it's that profound. I wish each of you much success in life. Once again, congratulations, the class of 2021.